actually been speaking about pitching for a show for about three years, like, to now. And I then went and had a little think and reflected on, I watched the show because I'd never watched it, reflected on kind of what I'd want, how I'd want to, like, create this show, the vision I had for it. And then basically was like, yeah, I absolutely want to do this show. And then, yeah, and that was when the kind of ball got rolling. We created the pitch. And then basically since then, I was like, spent the whole summer working on my vision and like what I wanted 9to5 to look like. And then it was auditions.
Find a show that was fun was the criteria, I think. It was find a show that was big and fun that would fit the Joseph Rowntree Theatre. The show choice itself was pitched towards the HMS. We have to be respectful when you choose a show. Do we think we've got the demographic? Do we think we've got the ability? Do we think this is something people are interested by?
Everyone always asks, like, what kind of inspired you with the dance moves you used or anything like that. And I always listen to the music. It just kind of, I suppose, pops in my head. And I have to play around quite a lot because I want to make sure it, like, looks perfect, because it's not about the moves themselves, but the way it will look kind of as a whole.
Right at the start, it was about organising the rights, getting the rights sorted. Then it was organising auditions. And then once the auditions were sorted, it was about announcing who was in the cast, sorting out prod applications and interviews, sorting out a prod team and then chairing the prod meetings, organising the rehearsals in the room.
There's always something happening all the time, and you can get a message at any time of the day saying, can you do this, can you sort this, and it's got to be something you've got to do really quickly. Newspapers, radio teams, everything like that around New York, and having to try and get your show out there. So calling up people, emailing people is something that you've really got to do.
I think getting to embody such a big character that people knew really well was just such a great feeling. Like being able to have that accent and have that wig and come out on stage and people just immediately be like, yep, that's Dolly. And the fun that came with being her, because like she's such like an inspirational and amazing woman, and like getting to embody her was just so much fun. So I think that's probably my favourite part of playing Dolly.
I think my favourite part of playing Judy was the fact that she's really, like, she'd just been dumped and she was feeling a bit, you know, sad, and we can all relate to that. And then she, you know, goes on this amazing journey and learns that, you know, her friends and, like, accepting and loving herself is all she needs. And I felt it was quite inspiring for me to like, play that part and go on that journey.
It wasn't easy to act in such a different way to myself. So when I was like on stage in costume with this full set, I felt like this is very easy to get into character now, and I kind of just, you know, went for it 100%.
What's it like being in a pit? Cramped? Warm?
You're freezing when you first get in there, because there's no heating. Then you're boiling when it ends. You're cramped in there, no room, pitch black, people stomping above your heads, but it's so much fun. Just one of the best environments.
Well, the pit is wonderful. Well, in a real theatre, this pit is lovely. Being in the Joseph Rowntree pit is great because you're there, you're in the atmosphere, you're seeing exactly what the audience are seeing in the show, and you have a great time.
I started doing technical theatre when I was 12. So I've done, 8 years amateurly and then a couple of years professionally.
Yeah. Whereas I've kind of dabbled in live sound, particularly like for bands, but I only joined TechSoc like 4-5 months ago.
I remember going to see Wicked when I was 10, and then I kind of caught the bug, if that makes sense. Then began performing in theatre, and then did some backstage work experience at my local theatre, and then that really got me interested in the production side.
Oh, I think since like literally primary school, I remember I got cast as the witch in like this pantomime thing we did, and then ever since I was like, oh, I love the drama, like I just really liked it.
I've always done dancing and singing since I was little, but CHMS was the first time I did full musicals, and it's been great.
Well, I mean, theatre kids like myself, we always overcommit. You know that.
I wouldn't consider myself a theatre kid.
You are, you're in CHMS, you're a theatre kid. Shush.
Even though it is a lot of work, and this time she was feeling so stressed, and you're like, oh my god, like, why have I signed up for this? What am I getting from this? When it all comes to work in the end, and you see the show in the local newspaper or like on the radio, and you think, wow, I've done that, like I've put it out there, and it's just such like a rewarding feeling. So it, when it all comes together in the end, it's just so worth it.
I just think it's really refreshing. There's like nothing, it's so different to being in a lab or being like just in a lecture theatre and being lectured at, and it's just like you get a bit of movement, a bit of exercise, obviously like your voice, and it's just like a really friendly, upbeat thing to do. So I've really loved doing that outside the degree.
It's so rewarding seeing the end product of it, and it's so lovely being around people that are so similar to you and have the same drive as you.
Yeah, I think I really started the year being like, am I really wanting to commit my life to CHMS for another year, particularly the Masters? But as soon as the show got announced and the pod team was announced, I was like, I did not want to miss the opportunity, especially after COVID. Like, none of us had performed in so long.
It's always such a good experience because you start off with nothing and you end up with almost professional end show for a uni production. So it's the feeling that you've put so much time and effort into that that has then paid off in such a obvious way. And I mean, we got some people come up to us after the shows about just about the tech and stuff, and that's always really lovely.
Yeah.
You do it because at the end of the show, you're there in a theatre and you have 360 people all cheering, laughing, clapping, enjoying themselves, the cast are enjoying themselves, the band are enjoying themselves, and it's just a really great feeling, and that's why we do it, I think.
Because I kind of came in a little bit later, the process was quite full on straight away. It was kind of different to normal process because I kind of had to jump straight into thinking about like making the set straight away, as opposed to kind of drafting and sketching and stuff. So it was intense, it was busy, but no, it was good. It was really fun.
Yeah, it was intense for me too. There was a lot of cast, and it was really creative, getting to like put everything together and go to charity shops every day, but it was like quite technical as well, thinking about costume changes and stuff like that. Yeah.
You know, everyone was talking about doing lockdowns. There were so many newspapers and like media outlets just talking about how there was going to be a lockdown or restrictions. And I was like, fine, if we're going to have to do rehearsals, you know, like get six people and do rehearsals outside, we're going to have to do them outside, because we hadn't done Change It, which if you don't know, it's like one of our biggest numbers and one of the hardest and challenging numbers to do. And we hadn't finished it. So I was like, we're gonna have to just go outside, 30 of us, you know, and get cold in January. But yeah, so that was the time that I was really stressed, but then got to January and we were fine. And then when everyone got COVID, that was also quite stressful.
My two favorite parts were actually believing myself that I could do a part like this and be in a show like this and be in front of an audience like it was, because I just never thought I could. And then getting friendships like this, that just was an absolute added bonus that I would hope would come out of it, and very glad it did. Yeah,
I'm gonna be cheesy and agree that number one, meeting these lovely ladies and becoming close friends has been lovely.
Yeah.
And performing with them on stage, it was amazing. Mm. Watching them shine, it was fabulous. And I think my second favourite part was maybe the first time that I walked out on stage and the audience was there. Mm. And that feeling in the song 9 to 5, it was just amazing.
Yeah, I feel the same. Obviously, it's been a wonderful experience, and like I've got two wonderful friends out of it as well. Obviously more friends, but like, more than just two, but obviously it's been wonderful to share the experience. And also singing Get Out and Stay Out was my moment of the show, because I couldn't do it a week before the show and I was getting really stressed, and I just went out there and did it, and it just felt amazing to just scream pretty much.
Probably show week. It's just that kind of like
it's the rush.
It's the rush. It's that. It's the peak of the mountain. You know. It's like it's finally some the point that we could really enjoy the time. The
fruits
work
of our
labour.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This was my first ever time being involved with CHMS. So obviously I didn't know anyone prior to joining 9to5. But now I feel like I've met some like really lovely people and like really nice people who I've really clicked with.
To be fair, out of everything we built, I think that was probably my favourite thing that we managed to do.
That was so good when it came down the first time.
It was just such a nice moment.
Started.
It was quite nice as well because me and the guys from TechSoc kind of did it together because they sorted out the lights and then we had a moment where we were like, how are we going to put all these lights on this one side and get them to work? I ended up using hot glue and cable ties and just cable tying it all at the back. It looked a mess from behind, but it looked great from the front, so that was fine.
I had a lot of hot glue.
Yeah, it's honestly, I love hot glue. I swear by it, I use it all the time.
So the second change it rehearsal, I was really worried about that number because we'd done it before Christmas and I knew it wasn't right. So I went away over Christmas and thought about it for days, weeks. It was intensely hard and we did the rehearsal and then everyone got COVID, but we did the rehearsal and it was incredible. And I was like, oh my God, we have a show. I was literally on cloud nine at that point.
My favorite moment was the sits probe.
The sits probe, yeah.
That was when you see everything come together because it's when you sing, the whole cast is there and it's not often that the whole cast is like at rehearsals. And the whole cast was there. We all got to see numbers that we weren't in and hear it with the band. And we all just had chills. We were all crying. We realised we were like, well, we have an actual show. And we were just so excited to put it on.
100% CHMS has shaped my experience. I don't think I'd be, would have done like near as much acting as I would have if I wasn't part of CHMS. And it's definitely something I want to do more into the future. So, you know, I have CHMS to thank for that.
The 9to5 has been, it's been the highlight of my year so far. CHMS is a family and I'm so proud to be a part of it. That's all there is to it.
Well, it was just incredible really, like the amount of satisfaction you get out of it, the amount of like pride I've had throughout the process of like how characters and how my cast have like evolved themselves as like actors. And their ability to like, oh my goodness, like dancing and choreography and the way they've portrayed their characters has just like developed. It really gave me such a sense of pride. So as much as it was obviously a very busy and tough, like we started working on it not like 9 months ago, discussing it a year ago even, I definitely realised like it was something I wanted to commit to and I just learned so much from it. So it was definitely worth my time.
CHMS has definitely shaped my uni experience. I've honestly made some of the most incredible friends through CHMS and it's kind of helped me have more confidence in myself as well. Putting yourself out there, going for auditions, like just enjoying yourself and what you're doing and being surrounded by just such supportive and kind people. I do really think that CHMS is a very, very wholesome society.